You did talk about education and health, but let me move on to the topic of health, right? So you spoke about that the national government will be withdrawing reserve funds from PhilHealth worth more than 90 billion pesos under the fourth trigger for funding unprogrammed appropriations. So you've always felt that unprogrammed appropriations were controversial because you're appropriating them and there's no money. You said that on Head Start, right? Ang tanong, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto has said, walang gagalawin naman from PhilHealth. Parang sinagot po niya yun.
Hindi, oh, ganito, ganito nga.
Oo.
Ganito
Oo.
muna.
At ano na po ba talaga?
If we look at the SONA of the president, so meron siya mga health programs, okay?
Oo.
Marami doon about the benefit packages of PhilHealth.
Yes.
Pinagmayabang niya, dodoble ang benepisyo sa ganito. Yung mga generics drugs ganito, lahat mga para ano, it's all an increase or a rise in benefit packages. Oh. Therefore, PhilHealth ang inutusan niya doon eh. Oh. Tapos, and then although he did not announce this in the SONA, but
Yeah.
we know that there is a circular na around 90 billion, I think the Department of Finance discovered or found 90 billion daw pesos of funds in the PhilHealth na medyo maybe they will call this as idle.
Underutilized.
Idle or underutilized, and then sasabihin nila, ito yung ano eh, this is the technique, they thought of during the Maharlika debates eh. Yun eh, that Maharlika will sweep the idle funds eh, so that Maharlika will be the one to invest. Ito naman ganyan yun. So they found out 90 billion idle funds ng PhilHealth kukunin because unprogrammed fund, because this is the fourth trigger. Ang ginamit ko lang fourth trigger, but this is really the parang the fourth one of the four circumstances when you can now fund the unprogrammed appropriations. Yun yun. So medyo there is inconsistency, hindi ba? Di ba? The president announcing to the people, PhilHealth will give you all of this. Doble na yan. Tumaas na yan. And then, yung agency na yon tatanggalan ng 90 billion pesos. But my question is ganito. Yung 90 billion pesos, subsidy, most likely subsidy from the national government, given by the national government to PhilHealth. But when the national government gives PhilHealth subsidy, that is in the nature of premium contributions of those who cannot or do not make actual contributions.
Yeah.
So
I think the bigger question is why is it underutilized?
therefore members funds din siya.
I see.
That is my point. When the government gives the PhilHealth subsidy ito to pay for the premium contributions of your members who are not actually making premium contributions, therefore members money na yon, beyond the reach, the sweeping power of the national government, bawal na yon. Okay, why underused? Yan ang isang magandang question.
Yeah,
But
why?
okay. Pero ganito. Number one is this is for health, di ba? Kung let us say wala namang claim, wag piliting ubusin. Mabuti nga may reserve funds. We are praying for a healthy nation eh. Mabuti nga. But of course, a lot of our countrymen have health problems. I-review siguro nung PhilHealth yung mga packages nila. And then, at tulungan yung talagang mga nangangailangan ng tulong. Kasi ang question ko nga doon is, kung meron na nga tayong universal healthcare program, automatic na membership sa PhilHealth, bakit ang napakarami pa rin lumalapit sa opisina naming mga public officials na parating it's about their hospital bills, it's about their doctor's professional fees, it's about purchasing medicines or maintenance medicines, mga ganun. So
Oo.
there is really something wrong. Tapos
Yes. And considering there's the Universal Health Care Act,
correct,
where
correct.
the vision of that was to give health care for free for all Filipinos.
Correct. Pero yun nga, it's just in the nature of a subsidy. Yan lang yun eh. We gave it a very grand name, universal health care. Pero covered kayong lahat. And these are the packages. So pwede ka ngang may health concern na wala sa package. Eh. Then therefore, these are the packages. And then these are the accredited hospitals. And these are the accredited practitioners. Ang dami mong problema eh. Pwede ka magka health problem, but you do not go to an accredited hospital, or your doctor is not an accredited health provider. So yun. So you will not be covered. So ganun na nangyari. So, but my point is, PhilHealth was given a lot of instructions and responsibilities by the president in the SONA. Mm-hmm. Maasahan ng taong bayan yan. Let us not disable the PhilHealth by getting so-called reserve funds, kasi ayaw ko rin pilitin ang PhilHealth gastusin ang pera kahit walang dahilan gastusin. Mm-mm. Hindi naman siya normal agency. Ano siya eh? It's a health insurance fund agency. Hindi kung may fund yan, we should be happy that there is a fund. Pero wag naman nila ipagkait syempre sa mga talagang nangangailangan. So, from the legal point of view, sa pagkakaintindi ko, when the national government gives a subsidy to PhilHealth, this is for and on behalf of the members who are not able to contribute. Therefore, these are members' funds already.
Okay. All right. Now, my last question is, was there anything that you believe the president should have talked about in the SONA? I mean, it's very difficult to talk about everything, but you did say that he failed to address issues such as housing, traffic, and the PUV modernization program, and the national debt. Right. Some have said they would have wanted to hear the ICC, for example. So, ang daming iba't-ibang mga opinion. Pero what do you believe was an important issue that the president ignored or could have?
He did not ignore agriculture, pero parang kulang eh. I mean, puro promises, parang puro future tense pa rin ang agriculture. Kunyari, for example, i-connect natin, meron, sabi niya, yung first 1,000 days. Gusto niya palakasin yun, di ba? We feed our children sa first 1,000 days. But hindi ba for sure, although sinabi niya DOST is developing some nutritious food and drinks. Hindi ba automatically sa ang thinking natin sa first 1,000 days may gatas? May component ng gatas eh. Oh. Therefore we will be importing all of this kasi ang production natin ng milk sa Pilipinas is 1% of what we need.
Interesting.
So yung mga ganun sana, that's part of agriculture. So ano yung mga actual nag-distribute ng mga inahin, nag-distribute ng mga fingerlings. So, pero ano ba? Ano na? Did it lead to improved and increased production? Mm-hmm. So yun, sana more on he mentioned agriculture, but sana more on agriculture because yun talaga, ako paniniwala ko rin, Karen, you know, even this inflation thing can be anong tawag mo doon, fought with more production in food items eh.
Yeah.
And then of course yung idea na about Kadiwa, I do not know why the president is, you know, so impressed with Kadiwa. But it is a discount store. It's a pop-up discount store because you cannot locate a discount a store in a permanent location because advantage ng community doon, sila lang yung access sa discount store. So it's a band-aid or a superficial solution. Ang hanapin natin is yung pangkalahatang pagbaba ng presyo ng pagkain because of greater production.
All right. So last word, Senator Pimentel, I think, in what what should be, I think, what should the president watch out for, considering he had a well-received sauna, right, by all sectors? But what should he watch out for to ensure that he doesn't lose his political capital in the coming months, and especially with the midterm elections coming next year?
Well, make sure the quality of the persons he will be appointing. Make sure that, you know, these people have public service in their hearts, no? hindi lang yung position ang habol nila. And then crack the whip on your people, make them all feel the urgency of the situation. All hands on deck.
Okay.
Again.
Especially with inflation and food prices.
Yes. Oh, kasi ito lang ha. The president announced yung ako sa akin, unbelievable employment rate figures, mm-hmm. and also an unbelievable poverty rate incidence figure.
Mm-hmm.
That was on a Monday. And then 2 days later, Karina hits, the super typhoon hits. So, I'm sure kahit yung figures na yon no longer hold 2 days after they were announced. So ano tayo, we have a lot of problems. Sabi ko, at least naka one down, 99 to go. Dun sa 99 still to be, so ano lang po yung figure of speech lang po yung 99. Yeah, it can be 999 other problems, but you know, siguro the president should now impress upon his people, lahat ng appointees niya, the entire bureaucracy, we have to act with urgency. We have to analyze what is the real problem. Sa root cause tayo tumingin. Wag na po yung mga superficial, artificial, and temporary measures.
On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, sir. It's been a pleasure. I do hope you return to Head Start soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Senate Minority Leader, Senator Coco Pimentel. Thank you.